suppose, how are you finding training in this heat? Is it hot or not too bad?
Well, it's not too bad. I saw on Thursday it was a bit of a heat wave in the 30s, but this is really nice. And just, I think I had to get more over the fact that I'm training with all these guys rather than the heat. So no, I'm just real happy being here.
How was it? How'd it go?
It was good. Hopefully you guys weren't filming, because straight away I dropped the ball and fell over on defense. So
that.
Yeah, that just shows, you know, I haven't been in a team environment for a long time, but for me, being here is like a dream come true. I grew up watching the Rabbitohs. Greg Inglis was my favourite player growing up, and so I parked up, got out of my car, and just stood and like looked at this field. And I was just like, man, I've only seen photos and videos of this place. So yeah, still pinching myself that I'm here.
So a dream of yours. How did you end up not going down the league route? How did you end up with?
My dad actually didn't tell me. When I finished high school, my dad didn't tell me about the offers that I actually had in league until I signed with rugby. But I'm happy with that. And just being here again, you know, it's just real cool. And yeah, sorry, I'm still getting over it. I'm still pinching myself. I saw John Sutton. Sutto, he's one of the players I grew up watching. And, you know, getting to be out there on the field while he was coaching was just, you know, something I could never dream of. So.
And you're good friends with Latrell, are you? Is that how? Yeah. So how was that? I guess, was he helping you out on the field a bit?
Yeah, he was actually laughing at me more than helping me. So, but it was good though. It was good to just be able to put faces to names and actually meet a lot of the boys that, you know, I'll talk over on social media with. So, yeah, again, I just keep saying it, but it's like a dream come true being here. I'm just still pinching myself out.
Is it something you might consider doing, switching to league one day?
I'm not too sure. I felt like a lot of the things I've done in rugby I've wanted to tick off in terms of goals, but there's still a few things that I'd like to do. But if I could have the opportunity, I think it would be something awesome. I think I said a couple of years ago that this would be a dream to play league, but hopefully I'll still have time to do it. I'm a bit young now, so hopefully these legs can still carry me.
So if they called you up, you wouldn't say no to playing?
See how we go. See how we go. If Greg Inglis called me, then probably I'd just go, yep. How much? I'll do it for anything.
But, so you could be playing next season, maybe?
Nah, I'm still with rugby. So I think the reasoning for me being here was I reflect on sort of the year I had this year, and it wasn't one that I was fully happy with. So I think going into next season with the Blues, I wanted to do something different. I wanted something that would add a bit of an edge, and, you know, being here in an environment like the Rabbitohs, a team that I watch, a team that I respect a lot, getting to rub shoulders with the boys, I feel like that would give me that edge just to get another spark back in. And yeah, just looking forward to next season as well.
What is it from today's training that you'll take back with you to the Blues?
Just so much more respect for the boys, eh? Like, there's so many different pictures in terms of rugby, and so it's a lot of eyes up, quick decisions that you have to make. Like, I was only on the field for a little bit, and still I'm already like over. Got so much information in my head because I was just picking the brain of, you know, like Alex Johnson and Tyrone Munro, just all the boys, just asking them questions. And so I think taking back after this week, probably better eyes up decisions would be where I'd go, because I'll probably go start talking to Latrell and Jack and Cody and ask them questions about attack after this. So, yeah.
Was there a bit of Kiwi New Zealand banter out there?
Oh, a few of the boys are Kiwis anyway, so it was all good. Just, and like, a few of the boys are Pacific Islanders, so we all got along. And again, just getting to talk to them over social media and then coming here and putting like names to faces and actually getting to say hello, yeah, just made it a lot more easier.
And how did they like it? I mean, the All Blacks are such a big game brand. It must be quite cool for them to have someone come in and train with them as well.
Oh, I don't know if they were excited as I was, but they were asking questions about it, especially when it came to outfitting with Adidas. That was that was one of the questions I got, but... again, like, it was, I think I was more real excited just to rub shoulders with a lot of the boys today, and yeah, real looking forward to the week.
And you got the team kit.
I know. How's it look? No, I was yeah.
Shut up.
I saw it. They're like, here's your kit. And I went, can I keep it? Please. But yeah, I'm just, again, just real stoked to be here.
Yeah. Anything else you wanted to add?
No, I just want to thank JD and everyone for, you know, allowing me to do this. I know. Not many other rugby players can get the opportunity, or say they had the opportunity to do this and learn from the other code. So yeah, I'm just real grateful.
Would you like to see more rugby players coming over?
I feel like
league fans.
Yeah, oh, a lot of league fans, and because everything is just so much more quicker here, I feel like it would help when it comes to the rugby field, especially for backs. I know once, like, the aerial game comes and like gets involved, that's where it helped me, especially as a winger, making those decisions as well. So yeah, it'll be pretty cool. I know Geordie was the first to do it. He was with the Storm earlier this year. I remember TJ Pitanata talking about the Roosters. So there's rugby players that do talk about it, but yeah, I'm just real lucky to be here today.
You'll be back then?
Hopefully. Hopefully the Blues let me.
Are you hoping to wear the jersey in a game next time,
mate? Oh, that would be like an actual dream come true. So that's one of those like life goal things. So yeah, how we go.
How would that compare to wearing the All Blacks jumper?
I think for me, the ultimate was always the All Blacks. Growing up, having rugby, being in a rugby household, but again, Roosters was introduced to me when I was a young teenager. So again, seeing the boys, because some of the guys are still here that I was watching growing up, like Alex Johnston. So yeah, it would definitely be mean a lot if I got to put this jersey on, but still got things in rugby to tick off.
Yeah. Not the Warriors jersey, not the up the Waz.
I'm too much of a Rabbitohs fan to say it. I had so many people ask me, say up the Waz. I'm like, no, up the Rabbitohs, man. So, yeah. Nah.